A few days ago, Airtable came out with a surprise announcement that they had just released some cool updates to the interface features and functionality of the tool. We're going to be unpacking all of these new features and updates in this video, so if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you build better no-code tools. I'm talking about no-code automation, no-code organization, databases, all of that fun stuff is what we cover here on this channel. Before we get into the heart of this video, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. If you're kind of new to no-code tools in general, there's a lot to learn and to catch up on. So I want you to start off with my Airtable crash course. It's going to go through all the key features of the Airtable software so that you can understand how all the different components work together to help you work more productively. Grab that crash course at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I will include links around wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen here. We have got to take a look at all of the new changes that have come to the new interfaces. So these are updates to the features on Airtable interfaces. If you are newer to interfaces, essentially interfaces allow us to share access to our underlying database with people on our team, and we can eliminate their noise so that they're not seeing all of the different pieces of data. Instead, we can give them pages and let them look at just the things that they need to see. We can allow them to edit what they need to edit, and view, delete, etc., the stuff that they need to have access to. So inside of this, we have some new changes, and I want to start by taking us over to the Airtable blog. So over here on Elevating the App Building Experience, again, we will include a link to this blog post wherever you found this video. But here are the key components of this. They're announcing new features for the building, sharing, and connecting of your most critical apps. So I'm going to scroll on down here and say the first one is really building in a more familiar interface. So what changes did they make? Well, they talk about how that you can be using a table layout, or they believe that anyone should be able to spin up new workflows without implementing code. So kind of reiterating the mission. But what they really got to here was improving the properties panel. The idea here is that you can quickly find what you're looking for, as they say, without getting lost in configuration details. So let's flip on back now to this example interface, and I want to really go through what's different and what's in a new place. So over here on the right-hand side, this has a little bit of a new feel to it, and it's because I'm clicking into the element here. So the thing that I'm building in the core center of my screen, on the right-hand side is where I see all the different options, the different filters I can apply, the different sorts, the different ways that I can view this data. And also notice that there's a hierarchy up at the top of the page, which I kind of clicked on without thinking. So up here we've got gallery, because what we're sharing here is a gallery view of this data. But if I go back up a level at the ultimately the page level, before I get into the gallery piece, this is where I've chosen the appearance settings. So if I wanted to make a different choice here, I could. I could make this a list view, for example, with just a simple click. So you see how quickly and easily we can start navigating again through the different components of what we're building. So I've set up at the page level my filter conditions here. I have certain things enabled, like searching and adding records through a form, which allows us to add this product. You'll notice that I've got the button down here, and I can add a button action to this. So in hitting this, I'm essentially creating new buttons up at the top of my interface that are going to do different things. So now let's go back to the gallery view or the gallery level. Clicking into the main element here, again, it's allowing me to go into that gallery element. We see it right here up at the top, and I can choose all my different components. Now, this isn't entirely different from the way interfaces was showing up before, but it is a little bit cleaner, a little bit nicer, and maybe a little bit easier to navigate. Everything that I'm doing and controlling with how I'm accessing this is here on my right side panel. Now, how is this different? Well, we used to have on the right side panel a couple of layers into things. We could also look at our different pages inside of our interface. And so now those pages have been moved over to the left-hand side. So here we see almost permanently on this left-hand side that I've got my product catalog, my orders page. If I click there, it takes me to a different page, and then my part finder. So I've got all these different components to my interface already set up, And they are always going to be displayed here on the left-hand side so long as I have that panel opened up. Now, if I want more real estate here on the main part of my page, the key building pieces are really here and then on the right-hand side as I'm going through the different elements. Well, I can get rid of this, closing it down by clicking on pages in the upper left corner. When I make that click, I get a lot more building real estate right here, making it much easier for me to build and navigate what I need to do as I go through the creation of my apps. But when I need to bring it back, it's a simple click, and there it is. Now that's going to take me to the next part in the blog post. If we scroll on down, we've got fueling apps with improved forms. And you might have noticed when I was in the interface that there's a nice little flashy pop-up that's saying, hey, check out our new forms. So what is happening here? Whether you're conducting a survey, collecting customer feedback, etc., the new form builder allows you to create and share interface forms with external and internal audiences. So this is a really big deal because previously when we shared an interface, the forms built in the interface were only accessible to people who had access to the interface. But what this is telling us is that we can now create forms that we can submit externally, but the form can exist inside of the interface. So presumably we can now share access just to the form without giving somebody access to the underlying interface and specifically, or additionally, the underlying data. So is that all true? At least that's how it reads. Let's go ahead and pop into our example and take a look. So if I were to add a form right here, I first have to choose what table that is going into. I'll say to the product table just to keep it simple, and we'll create the form. Now here inside of the form, you'll notice that the form kind of lives in a different section. I've got my interface here, but now my form is like at a different level, somehow inside the interface, but not really there with the other pages. So this is curious to me. Now, of course, these are the different elements inside of my table of products. So if I'm clicking around here on the right-hand panel again, I'm going to see all these different fields. So if I go back up to the top component of form, here are my different fields that are visible: product, order, and image. I can bring in new fields if I want to, or exclude them. I can change my product source here. Right now it's to the product, but I could change that if I needed to. I can either show or deny the Airtable branding. I can also bring in those customizable pieces of the form that we couldn't do previously, like adding a cover image here or adding a logo here. So these were parts that previously were unavailable in interfaces, and now we have access to. Now, when we submit a response, we can also toggle on, see who submitted this. So this would make sure that whoever is putting in data is getting their ID captured, their Airtable ID. So we can toggle that off if we want to anonymize the form results. We can also then toggle or change what happens after people submit the form and what that submit button looks like. Do we want to keep it submit? What kind of message do we want to have? And do we want to allow them to submit another response? So lots of advancements made on the form. Now, in terms of moving these things around, all we have in terms of actions are to remove. So I can click here and remove these components. And if I want to move them, I just click drag them around. And you'll notice that I can, in fact, squish a couple of different pieces onto the same row. So I've got product now right next to image. So some improvements here, to be sure. What I really want to see is what happens when we publish this form. So clicking on publish form takes me right here. Who can I share this with? So I can make sure that I'm sharing it internally to my Airtable sandbox. So I can say only people on my Gap Consulting account, or I can say anyone at a specific domain. So you have to have a certain email address in order to access this. Or, as you might have first seen, anyone on the web. So here is where I'm finally able to say, I created this form inside of my interfaces, yes, but I am making it available to anybody who has the URL. Also notice that I can require a password here. So I can simply come in, say anybody on the web, but they have to know the password in order to access this form. So these are some pretty sweeping improvements to the forms, and ultimately they're just making Airtable collaboration stronger and better. Now, flipping on back to the blog post, the last component here is about scaling and sharing apps more easily. So this is really talking about how we can actually share the app. So if we were to just quickly dig into that, flipping back into Airtable, I'll go back to my example here. And down in the bottom left of my interface, I can click on share. And here is where I have the new general access component. So what is this? This is showing me this is the interface and who can access it. And I can check it out, bring in access to my entire company or an entire department or something of that nature, making sharing way more simple inside of Airtable. And then I still have access to the components that I had before. So I can go back here and click on Manage Access and see all the different people who have access to this particular scenario. And I can come back here and make any changes I need to the different levels of permission. I can remove access, upgrade them, etc. Now remember, for folks who do also have access to your underlying data, not just the interface, but the underlying data, well, they are not going to be able to be removed from an interface, because if you have access to the database, by default, you have access to the top layer as well. So if you want to remove people who have access to the underlying data as well, you need to do that at the data schema level, not the interface level. All right. I know we went pretty fast here, but there's some big improvements to the interfaces, and they kind of snuck them out on us. How are you feeling about this? I've had some people on my team say they don't love the new changes. Other people say that they absolutely love the new navigation. It's quicker, cleaner, faster to work inside of interfaces. What are your thoughts? I'd love to hear them in the comments below. In the meantime, keep on building.